Good morning, Chairman. Good morning, committee, and thank you, Chairman, for posting this bill. I think it's an important bill that working families have been waiting for a long time to make a livable wage for how expensive our state is. Even though we did some reforms of a few years back and we did an amendment, a constitutional amendment, we set a floor, not a ceiling. And hopefully this is something we can get to get accomplished, and it would help a lot of working families in the state of New Jersey. As the middle class is eroded, we need to put some money in these people's pockets. It will also help employers be able to have a phase-in period, you know, until 2021. And by that time, in 2021, this will affect one in every four residents of the state of New Jersey. And sometimes we think of minimum wages as for kids, and it's not. It affects, you know, 91% of people over 20 years old and 44% of people over 40 years old. And a lot of people depend on these jobs to put, you know, a roof over their head, food on the table, and clothes on their back. So it should be a livable wage when in the state of New Jersey has such a high cost. And it's a great state, but and we're all, as with all of you, striving to make it a better state and a better quality of life for everybody. And when you have about 400,000 children that it would affect one of their parents, this is monumental to make sure that this is something we can get accomplished. You know, and we have to follow suit. Recently, in the last few weeks, California and New York City has followed suit. We can't lag behind. So we need to move the bar to somewhere that it's a fair, livable wage for our residents, and it's important for us to be able to put money in the pocket of people that normally put it back into our economy, so it'll be a good thing for everybody. Again, I don't like to belabor. Thank you so much for this bill. You know, I think it's great. Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, thank you for the opportunity to speak on this legislation. I'm happy to partner with our speaker to be co-prime on an important piece of legislation which will ultimately result in raising the minimum wage to a living wage. I'm sure the speaker has covered many of the important issues as to why we need to do this, but let me just tell you my own perspective. We have seen far too many times men and women who work very hard all week long at the minimum wage and can't earn enough to put a roof over their head or put food on the table without coming back to the state and asking for assistance. That's an economic situation that is a failure, and it costs us all money. An increase in the minimum wage will enable those people to wean themselves off that dependency. It will save us money in the long run. It will make the economy stronger, and it will help all of us. And so for that and all of the reasons that the speaker has said, which I would like to associate myself with, I would urge the committee members to favorably release this legislation so the full House can consider it.